Hello and welcome to the special collection of short business support podcasts that have been designed and created, especially with you in mind, the local business owner. This has been an unprecedented time of lockdowns. It's an experience we never would have imagined would exist in our lives. When would we have thought that our businesses would be closed for such extended periods? We're now into almost a year of it, so I know it's starting to affect a lot of us in a much stronger, impactful way than it was last year. This masterclass will give you practical information, professional tips, and inspiring ideas. I really want to help you revamp and re-energize both yourself and your business as you prepare to reopen your doors. I'm Mags McAlpin. My business is called Creating Retail Magic. It's a creative retail consultancy where we provide training, mentoring, and advice all about the creative side of retail. We call it retail theatre. So think about the magical customer experience that you can offer every person that comes into touch and contact with your business, your products, your brand, your space, and your services. It's that sensory experience, the sights, the smells, the sounds, and maybe even the tastes that makes your space special. So perhaps you'd like to take your pen, your notebook, grab yourself a cuppa, and enjoy these next 20 or 30 minutes as you listen to the Spring Into Retail 2021 program. I guarantee that you'll take at least a few new ideas and inspirations away that you should consider as you prepare to reopen your doors and to welcome your customers back in. And don't forget, of course, that your local council is there. It's just a phone call away. Please do give them a call or drop an email to them and see what guidance there is and maybe support that you can avail of. So enjoy the masterclass and I hope you get some nice tips.
Hello, welcome to the short podcast, Picture Tells a Thousand Words. In this 25 minute session, you're going to learn some really interesting professional and top tips of how to get really good photographs for both your products, your place and your people. Joining me will be Colette O'Neill from Colette Creative Photography. Colette's a full-time award-winning photographer herself, living and working right across Northern Ireland and indeed the whole island of Ireland. She works in many, many different sectors, photographing food, products themselves, public relations events, interiors, family, and especially her passion for fashion photography really sets her apart. So she's won many awards. And the interesting thing is she's a professional model herself, having many, many years of experience. So she really understands the value and the quality of having a relationship and a connection with the people that you're taking photographs of, the products, the place. So she's in our waiting room and I am delighted now to introduce her to come and join us and deliver the short session with us now. Hello, Colette, there you are. Delighted you can join us for a picture paint or tells and paints a thousand words, this short little webinar where we want to share these professional tips for really getting some great photographs on your phone if you don't have a professional camera. So I'm going to leave it over to you now. Thank you so much, Colette.
Hi, Mags. Thank you so much for having me. I'm delighted to be part of the podcast for Spring Into Retail. I'm delighted to be part of it. I'm hoping that I can kind of bring some useful information, just kind of talk about some of my experiences, what I do, and hopefully help people just kind of get the best out of their photography that's in their pocket to help it for their business and, you know, really keep the social media and keep your content coming. So yes, absolutely.
Fantastic. It's been one of my own business New Year's resolutions, considering the year we've had just gone. Mm. I really thought before Christmas, I thought, okay, 2021 is going to be the year where I make more of an effort to try and keep my social media up to date. I have to say, I go through maybe like many people, fits and starts of getting quite excited, taking arty, I think, photographs, yes, posting them. And then life intervenes. And I guess at the moment, like many of us, homeschooling, trying to work, trying to get food on the table, literally prepare meals, we're stretching ourselves thin on so many ways. So I'm delighted that we're able to do this little short session together. And there's some questions I actually have that are frequently asked questions from me, and also really from clients, other shopkeepers and salon owners, practice owners, things that they would ask me around photography. So this is the perfect opportunity to you know, really pick your brains, I think, is what I'd really like to do.
Do my best.
So I have a lovely presentation that you had shared. So let me just see if I can get okay. that organized for us now. Bear with me one second. And I'll see if we can get this turned on. So from the beginning, here we go. Oh my goodness, it's just on my back. So let me slide through. There we are. A picture tells a thousand words. Professional photography tips for your product, place and people. I'm going to let you take over from here, Colette. Thank you.
Okay, Mags, thank you so much again. So this is basically, we're going to talk about how we can get some good content. I mean, my top advice is obviously if you want great content, super high quality, you have to hire a photographer. And that's what I do. That's what I do every day. I'm full-time professional photographer. My area of expertise is commercial, primarily a commercial photographer, commercial advertising and fashion. So this is what I do. So what I would say is hire someone like me, but that doesn't always happen. We can't always do that. We need to feed the social media channels. I'm exactly the same, you know, I have to feed mine. So what we have to do is we have to capture content using our phones. We all do it. I do it. I mean, I share my professional pictures, the finished high quality edited shots, but to feed Instagram stories, to, you know, to keep that content coming every day, we gotta use our phones. So we have smartphones, most of us, in our pockets. So it's about utilizing those and keeping the content coming. So this is just basically an overview of what we're going to do. So we're going to look at some equipment and some lighting. We're going to then jump into the product and place. So first of all, equipment and lighting. So I mean, what are the best phones for product and lifestyle imagery? So really what it boils down to is that we're going to use the best. We're going to use the newest. Personally, I'm an iPhone 8 user. So Apple products, that's just kind of like where I am. It ties in with my Mac and my editing software. But really the phones that are out at the minute, the camera quality is phenomenal, I have to say. You know, the pixels that are coming out of these phones are incredible, actually, and under good conditions the results are really good. And then again, what we'll touch on later as well is some editing apps, and then what you can do with them are really, really good. So I mean, I have the iPhone 8, so there's also the Google Pixel, the Huawei, the Samsung, but really what it boils down is to the latest phone will give you the best pixels. So if it's either you're a store owner or a salon owner, if it's your phone, it might be worthwhile looking at an upgrade. If you do want to be feeding those social media channels, possibly an upgrade might be on the cards, or member staff, try and use the best and the latest ones. Not everybody has a digital SLR camera, so smartphone in your pocket. I mean, sometimes they say the best photo is taken is using the phone, the camera that's on you, and 100% of the time we have our phones in our pocket. Sure. About just taking the steps that we're going to discuss today is just about taking some time to try and get the best pictures that we can for your business.
That's exactly it. Yeah, a lot of customers would say to me, you know, I have my phone and my camera, you know, on my phone. I haven't a clue how to use it. And yeah. I'm totally in that boat as well. And I suppose to corroborate what you're saying there is, I would say based on personal experience, just have a play with it, you know.
Yeah.
Get a child to help you. You know.
Absolutely.
Well, that's it. I remember years ago when I'd be asked to work the video for my mom and dad, and now it's come back to haunt me. But I think really playing around with the features, get to know your own phone, mm-hmm. and exploring what mm-hmm. can be done that way. And I know you're going to talk about some really lovely third-party apps towards the end of this short presentation. Mm-hmm. But I think what I have found as well, one of the things I learned from a colleague that was working with me on some projects recently, he was very adept at using Insta stories on Instagram, mm-hmm. and he always takes his photos and videos through Insta, which was quite interesting. And I asked him why, and he says, well, I can do so much more with it Mm-hmm. That was kind of one little thing that I learned from him, which I could suggest people to try, you know. And you mentioned there about, you know, lighting being so important. Now, I remember, I'm totally going to misquote, was it Marlene Dietrich, maybe, always wants to have her photograph taken where she was lit from above?
Oh, yes. And for that kind of noir style. Yes, exactly. Absolutely.
Yeah. So tell us, what's your top tips about lighting?
Yeah, well, I mean, what I've listed out here, just really in an ideal world as a professional photographer, I use a mixture of daylight and I also use flash photography. My flash photography is difficult. It's hard to control. So what I have listed is trying to make it really easy for people. I mean, I said good, consistent daylight, and it's free. But the only small issue with that is you have to wait until it is right, really. So in terms of photography, lighting is the key. It's the magic key. I mean, we have to find good light. I mean, as a photographer, if I'm photographing a portrait, if I'm photographing a wedding, what I have to do is I have to find the light, and then I bring my subject to the light. My window is a big softbox, beautiful, natural, soft, flattering. That's what I'll do. That's where I'll bring my bride. I'll bring her up to beautiful light. So I've said here, so good, consistent daylight. And when I say that, I mean, avoid harsh lighting conditions. So if it's super sunny and you have streaks of very bright light and very dark shadows, that's going to be quite difficult. I mean, it can sometimes look quite artistic if it's done and handled in a nice way. Sometimes it can be quite interesting, but probably in terms of business and getting your product across, just consistent, really. So a nice cloudy, sunny day. We talk about that being really the ideal conditions, but again, in Northern Ireland, we don't always have that. And winter time, exactly. We don't have the daylight hours. So again, what I have then listed is some other options. So we have continuous lights, which you can get. Again, these things range in price. Your starter pack, say, for example, could be around £50 for a set of continuous lights. And I've actually, there's a quick photo of that one down underneath there, where you've got a stand and you have it's like a little pop-up softbox and it's a bulb. So that's called continuous lighting.
Okay.
The photo in the middle is a ring light. Lots of bloggers use those. It's your sort of tripod. It's got your ring light. And most of them, I believe, now have like a little a phone holder in the middle. So they know that you're going to be doing content to your phone, which is great for selfies, videos. So, and then the other option that I've listed there is studio light box. I mean, this one that I've listed is around £33. That's really cheap. You can go up. They go up to like 80, maybe above 100. Now, this one's a little small one. So if I have small products, again, it just kind of gives you nice, even, bright white background. So if you're photographing things that are not very big, it's quite handy. And it does give really quite nice results. As you can see there, that one uses like a little ring light up above. It's continuous lighting.
Oh yes, I see it there at the top. Do you know, that is a wonderful idea. And even just chatting now, how perfect would that be if you know, if you're a shop that was selling jewelry or accessories, perfect for that. But even homewares, cosmetics, perfumes, shoes, really anything, that would be really, really perfect for, wouldn't it?
Absolutely. You know? And honestly, like something like this little softbox, it'll give you really good results actually for not a massive, I mean, obviously that little picture is showing it there with a digital SLR, but to be honest, if you have again the latest smartphone and you have that softbox and you have your little product in there, and as you said, I mean, they range in size. I think this one's in around, maybe could be a 30 square, but you spend a little bit more, you get bigger. It depends what you're going to be photographing, but if you're selling mugs or handbags, or as you said, like makeup kits or whatever, like this is perfect. This is absolutely perfect.
It is. And you know, my goodness, we're halfway through our session already, doesn't it fly?
My goodness.
And I just, a little note on again on that slide you're showing is the tripods just reminded me that shouldn't everyone really have a tripod for their phone?
Absolutely. Well, I mean, for example, if this ring light that we have in underneath, I mean, if you're going to be doing stories or talking to camera, this is beautiful, flattering light. This, you know, what the ring light is really nice. It's really what all the bloggers are using. Yes. They're using ring lights, but for stills,
yes,
beautiful. For video, beautiful. And continuous basically means it's the light is on all the time, so there's no flash. So with a flash of light like I use, you have to very much control the parameters. But This what you see is what you get. And again, with the continuous lighting, you either move it forward, move it back if it's too, so you can basically, what you see is what you get. You don't have to wait for the flash to happen. So it's simple.
It's brilliant.
But it gives you lovely, consistent results, really.
Great. So that could be certainly for one of our viewers on this webinar, that could be their key takeaway moments. Just get yourself some lighting sorted out and a nice little tripod, you know, if you don't have them for your phone.
Absolutely. And from, quite a big investment either.
Yeah, that's exactly it. They really are quite, you know, I think a good return on that investment.
Absolutely.
And from lighting then, this is always one thing that I'd love to know about, you know, to really get some good information and guidance on photographing the products. So what would you say to us for that?
Yeah, so I have listed some points that we're going to talk about. So really, when people are looking at your pictures, you want their bait, right? So they, especially during lockdowns, people can't physically come into your store. So what they want to see, they want to see content. They want to see these photos. They want to see the detail. They want to see. So basically, I have talked about angles. So we want to take it from multiple angles. So we can look at, you know, up above, we can look down underneath, you know, but we want to come in, we want to show the detail. If it's a lovely dress and it's got a beautiful buckle, you want to kind of show those off, the fabrics, but basically then show it from eye level. You want to pick out your hero picture, so your hero picture will be usually eye level, to sort of give you that kind of lead in. But then people love scrolling, they love pictures, you know. People are very happy to scroll across multiple pictures, they, like I do every it's just what we do. We consume pictures. So really take lots, and then you can basically edit down. So say you take 30 pictures, you can edit it down and pick out 5 really great pictures. So, I mean, sometimes keep it consistent, you know. So if you are photographing a product on a particular background, or like a nice, say you have a nice wooden floor. Mm-hmm. I mean, sometimes a wooden floor can look awesome. You know, I have shot many things on floors, or I did a shoot not so long ago, and it was for like some pottery, and we were shooting it on lovely tables, and actually it was all daylight, it was actually all natural light, but we ended up, I looked around and I saw like a poured concrete surface, and I was like, we should just try over here. And it was beautiful. That it was just actually something really random, but you just have to sometimes look for those different wee areas, and then keep the consistency. So say you have a range, shoot them all on the same place, usually around the same sort of time. So then you're going to get a consistency look to it that we have coming through. Yeah. And then obviously you can control the exposure. So say you're looking in your phone, you can obviously click the point, you can control the exposure there. I mean, you can look at your focus to make sure that it's focused, tap, and you can lock the focus by holding the screen. And another top tip then, avoid zooming in. Oh. So say you're photographing a lovely set of earrings.
Yeah.
Zoom in on your phone, actually use your body, move and actually zoom in.
Okay. In. So don't use the zoom later on the phone then.
Zoom on the phone. No, it's really bad.
Okay. All right.
Uh-huh. Yep.
And then just, I guess, edit it in later on, zoom in on the edit stage.
Uh-huh. Absolutely.
And you say there are no flash. So what's that then?
Yeah. So again, the flash on usually on the phones are not great. That's what I'm saying. They kind of, they're not ideal. So really one of my biggest tips would be to try and not use the flash on your phone. So again, bring it to the window, bring it to the good light. If it's at the back of your store, bring it up to the window at the front, you know, again, nice, even lighting. You shouldn't need that flash. And if it's too dark, get that softbox, buy it, you know, buy the continuous light, and then you'll have the light, you know, so you don't need the flash. The flash is ugly on the phone. It's not, you know, it's not going to light it well, whereas you can do many other things to improve it.
Fantastic. And, you know, going from products then and looking at your actual place, we mentioned there in the store, I think people really want to be able to see what's going on in shops, even if they're closed at the moment or in salons. So as well as photographs of the products and creating the story of the service, I think it'd be wonderful if our viewers could kind of get some ideas on how they could still continue the story of their place, even though the doors are closed.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's about selling the business, you know, if it's a hair salon, if it's a chemist, if it's a clothes store, you know, pet grooming, we have to give it location, really. So what we need a good pictures of the outside. We want to do attention to detail. You want to take maybe the sign up above, the signage, you know, even sometimes, you know, if we're talking about interiors, you want to get a nice wide shot, you know, and so many of the latest cameras, they have lovely wide angles. Yeah, and you can get such like really cool, interesting sort of angles from there. Again, that feature was never there before. So we have really nice things that we can do there for wide angle. And again, best time, like we've kind of touched on that before. So again, super harsh light is going to be very difficult to control. So what you need to do is kind of really look at the best time of day to shoot it. So you need to look at a nice even lighting, so a nice cloudy day during the day. And again, not in the winter time, you're going to be careful of it being super dark very quickly. So you've got to look at the best time of for the light and take it then. So get creative, you know, if there are little areas that you have done. I mean, so many places now have like Insta friendly areas, you know, and if you have a client and if you're a hairdresser, you want to do, you know, before and after. So many salons have little Instagram areas where they might have keep a specific wall where you could even have your logo, your branding, but they encourage clients then they could have ring lights, you know. I have seen hair salons where they supply the client with a ring light and you've got your logo in behind and it's a nice clear wall and the client will do it, you know. They'll be over and they'll want their nice flattering ring light picture and they're going to be uploading that content as well, but you're controlling the environment. You know, you're giving them a nice clean background areas, so that'd be something to think about.
And I think, you know, on your point there of being creative, thinking about the angles from which you're taking the photo, so don't be afraid to hop up on a stool and take almost like a bird's eye view of your store at a really interesting angle, or again your window display, not just front on from outside, but maybe slightly inside your window from the interior.
Stick definitely
on a selfie stick and get a close-up of those beautiful things you have in the window.
Yes, definitely. I mean, that's what I would do. I mean, whenever I'm out on a job, like on a commercial job, like this is basically what companies hire me to do. The majority of my jobs would be come in. So they want internals, they want externals, they want headshots, they want sometimes product photography, they want a slice of life. So say it was a hair salon, for example, or a nail technician, they would want lovely, you know, details of like maybe hands cutting hair, or a chemist, you know, we want to get interaction. We want shots of the chemist. We want shots of the product. So it's about just capturing all those different little areas. So that's what I do. I mean, that's what I do with my camera, you know. And I said it's about trying to just use the phone that's there in your pocket to do it. Absolutely.
Absolutely. And goodness, we're coming to the end of our session soon, so I'm pumping you here for all this information. And you mentioned there about, you know, people in the business, your clients and your staff, which is a really important resource. I do want to ask you a little bit about that, but one thing I just want to ask you before we do, any top tips around this? I personally would have many challenges if I'm taking photographs of window displays that I've installed to try and again get some nice photographs and pop my hand inside the window to get the displays. But looking at attention to detail, and as you mentioned there, any guidance for us around how to deal with those pesky window reflections?
Yes, absolutely. Do you know what the honest answer is? It's really difficult. I struggle with it sometimes. First of all, make sure the window's clean. I mean, that's going to be one of the first things you're going to say, is it's got dirty marks on it. If it's got bird poop, you're going to have to clean that off, you know, and get it clean. That's really the first thing. Again, the light is so important. If it's a really super sunny day, you're not going to get the picture. You just won't. And then it's just about really experimenting. I mean, that's what I have to do. I have to experiment. I have to come down really low and then maybe shoot up in. Sometimes like getting a straight on shot is really difficult because you're going to get yourself in it. So really I just have to experiment with angles, you know, to try and avoid, say, getting the shop across the road in the reflection. So come down low sometimes is a good tip and shoot up into it.
Brilliant. Okay, top tips. And I remember again from art college many moons ago when we were doing photography using actual cameras and learning how to do the proper exposures and apertures, all of that. There was, you'll have to guide me, I can't remember now. How did we deal with at those times, you know, on unreal cameras even nowadays? Are there any type of filters or guidance you can give us on that?
Well, there were, for a digital SLR, for a camera, yeah. there was polarizing filters that you can use, and they do help with the reflections. They really minimize that. Whether you can do that on a phone, I'm not sure, but I know certainly if you have a camera, or you can attach, you just screw the little filter on and you can rotate it and it kind of like,
yes, even that's right.
Reflections, yes, absolutely. Yeah. But it's about experimenting. You know, yes. We talked before and we said, you know, you just have to really look, you know, keep control of that exposure, that you're not going to blow out the highlights, you know, so that we're kind of bringing the exposure down, you know, and then again, using our third-party apps, which we're going to move on to and say, you know, bring it, you know, we can things that it's difficult to control, we can bring highlights down, we can bring shadows up, so we can do that in those apps, which we're going to move on to. So yeah,
brilliant. And again, people, two things hopefully you've looked at for us here: taking some nice shots of others and getting people to feel comfortable, which is what you're all about in your profession, and then of course top tips on how to get that good photograph of ourselves. So tell us what to do.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, people I think are so important. I think it gives real personality. I am always including people in my pictures. If it's someone waiting in a waiting room to go in and see a solicitor, or you know, or someone sitting flicking through a magazine, or someone getting their nails done or their hair, or somebody in a chemist, I sometimes set it up, you know, when I say like, okay, can we borrow someone else, you know, somebody else who's staff, and they were like, yep, can you be a customer? Yes. And I'll set it up and I'll create the moment. So, and again, what we need to do is we need to light it, you know, if it's a very dark area of the shop, you need to light it. It needs to be brought towards the window. We got to pull in those soft boxes. We got to pull in those ring lights. We got to use the light. We got to make it, you know, we got to set it up and then we got to light it. So again, you got to think of your background. So if you're taking someone's headshot, you don't want a really messy background. You want to look at something that's going to be nice and clean. There's not something sticking out of their head or in behind their head. Yeah. So just think about what's kind of going on around the subject. And again, to pose or not to pose. Again, in my job, what I do when I go into, I actually do both. I would actually say, okay, let's do ones, and I'll get them to maybe work away on their computer. I'll maybe get them to answer the phone, and then I'll say, and then just stop and look up at me. And then sometimes I'll make a little joke and I'll get a natural laugh. So that's my insider secrets. Great. That's what I do. Usually then when the person, they're feeling embarrassed, but maybe then when you make a joke and you kind of like connect with them, you'll get a great shot, a really nice shot. So yeah,
I would
do both.
yeah. And you know, that's capturing again the character, the joy, hopefully the spark of light in your colleagues and in your staff and in your customers. How about getting something nice for yourself? How do we do that?
The selfie.
Yeah, exactly, the dreaded selfie.
So well, we have, I mean, portrait mode in an iPhone or you know, in some of the cameras nowadays is really good. I have to say it's a really great camera, a great lens on your smartphone. You know, it's going to give you that nice bokeh, the lovely blurred kind of background that we get. It does a pretty good job, I have to say. Brilliant. I mean, it's about angles. We're gonna bring the camera up slightly. We're not gonna try and take it down too low. We're gonna go up high. And if someone wants to take it, I think the portrait kind of mode works then from the other way around. You need to be having your phone nearly with someone else kind of taking it to use those front lenses. Sure. And again, we can do just try different angles. Again, come to the, find the light. Like I keep coming back to it.
Yeah.
Find
yeah.
the light, find the good light. If you're in artificial overhead lights, it's not going to work. It's not ever going to give you a nice selfie ever. Go and find lovely light towards a window. That is my top tip for selfies for is find the light, really find good.
I mean, try to look up to the lens, right?
Okay. Absolutely.
My goodness. And then I guess really you mentioned there earlier some really super apps that you personally like to use. Yeah. I know there's so many out there, but some that you kind of guidance was that you liked.
Yeah. Absolutely. I mean, I've just listed a few here. So the Photoshop Express is one of the free ones that you can get. I use the main Photoshop, and I would use Lightroom. So we have both of those. I have them on my computer and I have them on my phone. So I use those. But the Photoshop Express, I have to say, is really, really good for what you get with the ability to control exposure, you know, making it lighter, making it darker. It's done in such a lovely, controlled way. So I always think these things should be, and again, the second thing that I've listed there was Visco, which is like their filters and a way of editing your pictures. Always tread lightly. You know, I always say, you know, if you're going to try a filter, bring it down, dial it down. It's always about less is more. You know, never apply a full 100% filter. And again, pick something, try and find your style, you know, say like you use that particular filter. If there's one that you like, keep sort of to that style. And then you'll basically, if you're posting to your grid, you'll start to get a nice aesthetic, you know, things are going to start to look.
Yeah, that's a good point. So that if you for like a nice sharp black and white, for example, try and stick to that rather than jumping between that and maybe sepia or things like that. Have you a preference from a professional point of view, which might look better, sharp black and white edges or softer grays, or is it really about the story that you're telling?
It really does. I mean, personally, I don't like a sepia. I think I kind of like a true black and white. But again, as a professional photographer, we're always looking for areas that are not blowing. Like we talk about highlights not being too bright. We talk about shadows not being too dark. They have to be kind of controlled in the middle. So if your picture's super, super white, it can mean that your highlights are blowing. So then what you can do, again, some of these apps are phenomenal. You can go in and you can bring those highlights, save them, bring them back, and you can bring up the shadows. I mean, that's in terms of the professional editing software that I use, that's what I do. I do that every day. And you now have that ability to do that on your smartphone. Like it's amazing. Brilliant. And the last one that I've listed there is a program called Canva. I know you're going to do a social media podcast, but to be honest, this has blown me away. Canva is this incredible app. It is honestly, it's phenomenal. Even the free version, I would say get the free version, because it turns so you take your pictures, you're going to have your content sitting there, but it turns your phone into like a graphic design tablet. It's literally amazing. I may have clients use it. Some of my fashion clients use it, and they do all their design. Now they have the bought version. So I think it was around $10.99 a month. Yeah. And they use it on their computer as opposed to their smartphone. But honestly, it is amazing what it does.
So that's another one of your top
three templates are fabulous.
Fab. And I guess as time has come upon us now and we need to wrap up, thank you so much. Your top 10 tips to take away.
I'll run through these super quick. So yes, I mean, clean your camera lens. It seems really simple. The phone is in your pocket. Clean it every time you take it out to take a picture. Just give it a little rub, a nice little soft fiber cloth. Clean the lens. Update your phone. So keep doing all those updates. You know, go into the store and make sure that the operating system is up to date. This is so important. Keep it simple. It's easy. Don't try to overcomplicate something. Don't try to go real fancy. Just keep it really simple. Natural light, beautiful, flattering. Always keep away from the harsh sunlight. Very difficult to control. Keep away from artificial overhead lights, backgrounds. Think about them. Think about keeping it simple, keeping it neutral, keeping it interesting. Try to be creative, not too creative, Avoid the Zoom, and if you need to crop it later. You'll lose your pixels using your phone. Crop it later.
Okay.
Look at angles, try to move around, come up. You said, Mags, jump on a stool, try a high angle, come down really low, try low. Look at the details, you know, always try to capture those, you know, come in really close. Easy on the filters, as I said, dial it back too much, just bring them back. And then again, look at those third party apps. They're really good. They honestly, they will do incredible things to your pictures, I have to say. They're a brilliant way to, you know, take what you've done and then really, really enhance it and add that wee bit of magic to the shot. Yeah, absolutely.
My goodness. Thank you so much. Great top tips. And the good news is that all of these top tips are available to take to download as a free guide. So please go to your council website and you can download those for your use. And Colette, thank you so much.
You're so welcome.
For sharing all of these wonderful tips with us today in this short session. I'm very inspired and I'm very much looking forward now to putting them all into practice and seeing what I have learned from you today. I really do appreciate your time and absolutely wish you the best for your future for Colette Creative Photography.
Thank you.
From Colette O'Neill.
Thank you.
Again, thank you so much. We'll be delighted to catch up with you again at some point. And I know you have to leave us now, but lovely to see you. And thanks again now.
Thank you, Mags. Bye.
Bye. Great to see you. Bye.